consistently maintained that this great land of ours rightfully belongs to every Indian citizen, whereby we need to ensure that the rights of Indian citizens are protected against illegal immigrants. Hence the fact that the TRS in the MIM will not stand by the average Indian, but choose to stand by illegal immigrants so that they can politically gain, is shameful.
Now, you'd be forgiven if you thought that this was some kind of state election somebody hadn't told you about, or perhaps some kind of big by-election to the Lok Sabha. But no, it is the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation. That's right, a municipal corporation election that is seeing the big guns of the parties involved come out, all guns blazing, with the kind of things you would normally hear only in a top-level election. Political temperatures are soaring in the great city of Hyderabad in Telangana. BJP's Telangana chief Bandi Sanjay Kumar, while addressing a roadshow, proclaimed that his party will carry out surgical strikes in the old city of Hyderabad to drive out illegals and Rohingyas. Oasi has hit back at the BJP, daring Prime Minister to do a surgical strike in territory he alleged is occupied by China in Ladakh. The Telangana Minister K.T. Ramarao has also tweeted asking the BJP if they will kill crores of Hyderabad people just for the sake of a few votes. The Hyderabad civic polls are slated for the 1st of December. The run-up to the election has witnessed a very, very high-octane, unusually high-temperature campaign with invocations of things you normally hear in a Lok Sabha election, like Jinnah and Biryani and surgical strikes and soldiers and borders and anti-nationals and infiltrators. It's a civic municipal body election. So why is it so important to the parties involved?
If you support OIC here, OIC will become strong in Uttar Pradesh. And what does OIC mean? Who is OIC? OIC is Muhammad Ali Jinnah's new avatar. We must defeat him.
अब बीजेपी वाले तो ऐसा दिख रहा है कि कुछ समझ में नहीं आ रहा बीजेपी को, इतना फ्रस्ट्रेशन का शिकार हो गए. हैदराबाद को आ रहे तो बाबा जरा इनको अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह की बिरयानी तो खिलाओ, थोड़ा होश ठिकाने आता.
ఈ ఎన్నికలో భారతీయ జనతా పార్టీ మేయర్ అభ్యర్థిగా గెలిచిన తర్వాత బిడ్డ నీ పాత బస్సులో నీ పాత బస్సు మీద సర్జికల్ స్ట్రైక్ చేసి వాళ్ళ ఈ రోహింగ్యాలను.
టిఆర్ఎస్ ఇన్ ది ఎంఐఎం విల్ నాట్ స్టాండ్ బై ది యావరేజ్ ఇండియన్ బట్ చూస్ టు స్టాండ్ బై ఇల్లీగల్ ఇమిగ్రెంట్ సో దాట్ దే కెన్ పొలిటికలీ గెయిన్.
So it's only a civic body election, but what is this civic body all about? What all does it cover in Hyderabad? Let's give you a geographical look at why the GHMC, the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation, is pretty, you know, let's not play it down also. It is a pretty powerful body. So here's what it actually covers. This is so that you know exactly what's going on. Okay, this is the wrong graphic. Let's play the other graphic for just a moment. But okay, let's play the first. Okay, I apologize for that. Why this is important to the BJP is the first point that I want to highlight for my viewers, because you're probably wondering, why is the BJP sending all its big guns to Hyderabad for a civic poll? Let's tell you, it's a preparation ground before the 2023 Telangana election. Aims to increase the presence of the BJP in Hyderabad and therefore in Telangana, because the BJP has just won an important Lok Sabha bipoll there. They've also managed to get state bipoll, I beg your pardon, and also performed quite well in last year's election, the Lok Sabha election in Telangana. So they want to replace the Congress as the arch rival of the Telangana Rashtra Samiti of K. Chandrasekhar Rao, who is the incumbent chief minister of there. And of course, like the BJP wants to do in many states, they want to break the grip of the regional parties. They're trying to do that in Bengal with Mamta's Trinamool. Here they want to do it with the Telangana Rashtra Samiti. So that's the BJP's master plan. In one way, it explains why this is such a high-octane campaign. So, the BJP's top guns in Hyderabad. Let's tell you who the top guns are who've been campaigning in Hyderabad. Imagine, Devendra Fadnavis from Maharashtra has been here to campaign. Yogi Adityanath will be holding a roadshow and a public rally on November the 27th. Remember, polling is on the 1st of December. You've got JP Nadda, who will be visiting Malkajgiri constituency, which comes under the GHMC on November the 28th. Amit Shah will be holding some kind of a roadshow on November the 29th in Secunderabad, which is a twin city of Hyderabad. Today you saw, of course, Union Minister, the firebrand Smriti Irani, also in Hyderabad. So as far as big guns are concerned, the BJP has left no stone unturned to really bring them out. So what is the GHMC all about? Let's show you what the jurisdiction is of the GMC. It covers Hyderabad and the neighbouring Rangareddy district, Medchal and Malkajgiri, as well as Sangareddy. So this is a pretty significant geographical spread that is governed by the GHMC. 24 state assembly constituencies come under the GHMC, and 5 valuable Lok Sabha constituencies are also covered by the GHMC geographical limit. So it's not small potatoes. This is an important body, but at the same time, it is just a municipal body for the elections of which we're hearing all these things being said. Welcoming onto the show now, Krishank Mane, leader of the ruling TRS. We have Krishna Sagar Rao of the BJP, and we have Atiku Rehman, who is an Islamic scholar. We had also invited the AIMIM, but they've declined for some reason to join any discussion on this show. What their reasons are, I'm not aware of. Let's go first across to Krishna Sagar Rao, who's with me. From the BJP, Krishna Sagar Rao apologizes, not with me yet. Krishank, coming to you now, this is a question that is a lot of people are wondering about. I've tried to make some sense of it for our viewers, but you know, Jinnah, biryani, surgical strikes, illegal immigrants, that appears to be the highest decibel conversation happening around this election. Or that at least is what the BJP wants to make it out to be. What is your view on this? Because outside, nobody can hear anything else. The issues are being lost in the noise of things like surgical strike and biryani.
Well, Shiv, initially, we could clearly understand that the Bharatiya Janata Party is rattled because once Honorable Chief Minister KCRG has spoken about the farm laws or Government of India not giving a single rupee for NDRF funds for the Hyderabad floods. You know, these are the things which we want them to speak, actually. When ministers from Delhi, when union ministers are coming to Hyderabad, the first thing which the people of Hyderabad would want to listen is, what are you going to give, or at least what have you given to Hyderabad? But instead of that, you know, it is so astonishing, Shiv, that what a union home minister couldn't do, they expect a mayor to do, to stop illegal immigrants or to pick up immigrants or to do surgical strike. I mean, it is the duty of the union home minister to identify, detect and deport. It is their prerogative. Those are the powers of the government of India. But now they say that if they win a mayor post in a municipal corporation, they will identify and they will do surgical strike. Don't you think, Shiv, that if Pakistanis are there in the heart of the nation, isn't it a failure of the Ministry of Home? Isn't it a failure of Amit Shah ji? Shouldn't he resign if Pakistanis are living in Hyderabad and they should do surgical strike?
Okay.
Isn't it a failure of or intelligence or BSF?
Atiku Rehman, what are you making of this particular rhetoric that's going on right now for a municipal corporation election, for God's sake? I mean, these are things you usually hear in a Lok Sabha election, But between Oasis party and the BJP, it is all about, appears to be a very polarizing kind of fight about nationals, anti-nationals, biryani, Jinnah, that kind of thing.
Shiv, you know, certain facts here need to be kept in mind. Number one is we are a multi-party system. And every political party that to a national party have the right to contest election in any part of India. So, these charges which are labeled against OVCG right now have been labeled against all, other parties, namely the BSP, firstly in UP, in Maharashtra too. There is, certain backwards who are coming out with the party. And ultimately, they turn up to be kingmakers, even if they are having one or two seats. So this is the reality of the multi-party system. If we are not, comfortable with it, are we ready to accept a two-party system? No, that's not possible. Now, herein, we need to keep the facts in mind that Muslims are a identity, and it's very, sickening to know that in India, still after 70 long years of independence, we are, are running an identity political entity, which is not good. So herein, a group of people are there called Muslims who have sacrificed their separate electorate shiv in 1947 for the sake of secularism. And now after 70 years, you need to say that
you're making a broader point, but that doesn't, Mr. Rehman, that somehow doesn't explain what the Majlis party is also doing, because the BJP, I'll leave it for Krishna Sagar Rao to say, but my sense is that there is a to and fro going on between two sides. And who benefits ultimately from the polarization, I'm not sure. But Krishna Sagar Rao, to bring you in, the big guns of the BJP are there. I mean, you have to explain this to us, Krishna Sagar Rao. Yes, the BJP takes all elections seriously. It does not look down upon any election because it is a civic body election. I understand that. But this is still very unusual. You have Smriti Irani, illustrious campaigner. Smriti Irani, J.P. Nadda is coming. Yogi Adityanath is going to be there. We know Amit Shah is probably going to have a road show there as well. This is a lot of firepower that the BJP is putting into this election.
Shiv, every election is a celebration of democracy. That is the ideology of BJP. And because we are a national party, we have tall leaders like Nadda ji and like Amit Shah ji, Smriti ji, Yogi ji. We are proud that we have leaders who can come and campaign for us. And for us, whether it is panchayat or parliament, the election is an opportunity to interact with the citizens, with the voters. And if we are in power, we give them a progress report. If we are not in power, we ask them for the vote so that we can come to power to serve them. So it is the servitude. It is the ideology of our party. We don't take any election less serious. We fight, and that's what the spirit of democracy is all about.
Rhetoric and the things being campaigned about, Mr. Rao, the Jinnah and the, I know Mr. Owesi said biryani as well, to get back at the BJP, but the conversation has been quite high temperature. It's been high voltage. It doesn't appear to be just about the local issues on the ground, but more about nationals, anti-nationals, surgical strikes, Jinnah, that kind of thing. For a civic body poll.
See, Shiv, right after the nominations, yeah, you're very right. See, immediately after the nominations closed, our campaign started with a charge sheet against the manifesto presented by TRS party in 2016. We charged them that they have failed in delivering all the promises, and they have failed at the civic infrastructure and providing civic amenities to the citizens. So we are on the hot button issues of the civic issues. But who started it? It is KCR who said, I am going to fight against NDA, I'm going to have a Hyderabad declaration. Then it is KTR who said that if you bring in BJP, there will be communal disturbance in this city. If you have us, there will be development.
Okay.
Now you tell me, shouldn't we react?
We are only reacting.
Okay.
Whether it is biryani or whether it is Jinnah or whether it is the barbed wire fencing at Usmani University, we are only reacting to what they have initiated in terms of the communal.
Krishan, the BJP has said this before. Otherwise, that all of this polarizing rhetoric has been in response to parties like yours, which have basically begun the campaign by saying that if you vote for the BJP, then communal flare-ups will happen in the state. And the BJP says it is merely reacting to that.
Shiv, I'm really glad that the BJP spokesperson has been frank enough and has accepted the fact that if you question BJP not giving funds or their draconian laws against the farmers or the power amendment bill or the funds to the state or GST compensation, or the Hyderabad floods, flood relief, if you question this, they will definitely bring out communal politics. That is what the BJP spokesperson is saying. And definitely, they will bring in all the national leaders up against one municipal corporation. I will not be
surprised
if Prime Minister comes in. I will not be surprised tomorrow if Prime Minister of India comes and campaigns at Adagutta in Secunderabad. So definitely, because that is their priority. Politics is their priority, not governance. Not supporting cooperative federalism. There is no cooperative federalism or there is no Team India at all. It is the same government of Telangana which has supported the government of India in many policies. During the COVID also, they've failed. They've absolutely failed. And it is our right to question them. They will come up with rhetorics. What may come, Ganga Jamuni Tehzeeb will survive. Law and order. Since 6 years, there have been no riots. There has only been peace. No breach in law and order in Hyderabad. And that shall continue. That is our government of Telangana's priority. That is KCRG's priority.
So basically what is happening here, Krishna Sagar Rao, Krishank says that the communal polarization attempt is the big hot button issue, apparently. I mean, if everything else is supposed to be talked about, the BJP has made it about polarization. Respond to that.
Shiva, I have already explained. I don't know where he got that. I have given a different answer. Maybe he's not hearing. What I'm saying is, we are questioning where are the double bedroom homes you have promised the poor. We are questioning where are the pothole-less roads you have promised. We are questioning where is the tank bund water which will be like coconut water which you have promised. We are promising where are the roads which have been widened. We are asking where are the slum redevelopment. These are the questions Bharatiya Janata Party is asking. But the answer to that is, if BJP comes to power in GHMC, you will see communal disturbance. That is the answer they are giving. If they are giving that kind of answer, can't we ask them? We have the right to ask them, what is MIM for you? Why are you putting MIM dummies against MIM? Why are you using MIM to come to power in GHMC and in the state? So it is, of course, a political question.
Okay.
But it is also a question which pertains to the welfare of the citizens of Hyderabad, because MIM is having a fiefdom of its own. Hmm. There is nothing called law and order in the old city. And MIM is now governing the entire city, even on a platter by TRS to them.
Okay.
So now today, if we have misgovernance, it is because of MIM and TRS.
I have a small piece of breaking news.
In the civic area, it is because of their failure,
okay,
not because of us. So Shiv, it is very important for the voters of GHMC today to decide if they want development agenda or if they want a communally polarized division agenda of TRS and MIM combined. That is the proposition we are putting. We are not communalizing. We have no reason to communalize. And as I said, we are proud that we have leaders like Nagdaji, Yogi ji, Smriti ji.
No, I'm glad you mentioned this. Because there's been a reaction.
There's been a reaction
from the top level of the TRS. Let's just hear it, the government. Krishna Sagar Rao, one second. Just bear with me. Let me bring in KT Rama Rao, TRS leader, minister, Telangana minister, has mocked the BJP. I'll get a reaction from both of you for bringing its top guns to Hyderabad for this civic poll campaign. KTR says the BJP has forgotten that these are gully elections and the party might also bring Trump for the poll. So some sarcasm being employed by KTR there to mock the BJP. Krishan, you know, I get it. See, I get it. Sarcasm, taunts, jibes, sab kuch chalta hai in politics. That is not the problem. I am saying that, you know, is the TRS being overly defensive? You know, the BJP takes elections seriously. I am not speaking on behalf of the BJP. I am simply saying They see an opportunity to grow their lot in Telangana, and they believe that it's okay to bring their people from outside. They've done this in other states. Yes, it is unprecedented perhaps for a civic body poll, but that is the way the BJP election machinery works.
Well, Shiv, we started off our campaign with this manifesto of ours. We've released this, and clearly it's a report card of what work has been done and what is remaining. Yes, it's been 6 years simultaneously. I mean, you see, there are the same previous governments who've started out housing projects decades ago and they are still not filled. But yes, we are completing 90%. It was 2014. The same power cuts which were there before 2014 are not there anymore. No power holidays to industries. Water crisis. We are ready to talk about development. But are you talking about it? I mean, you are tying up us with this MIM. Aren't we contesting seriously with MIM? We should remind you that with MIM earlier also, the margin of defeats of almost 6 to 7 constituencies, divisions, were within 600 seats, 600 votes. So now, once again, we are confident of doubling up. Last time we won 5 divisions in the old city, and this time we are expecting to win 10.
Okay.
So you cannot say it's a dumb list or something. We are absolutely serious about it, and we promise, like in 2014 and 2018, how KCRG alone became the chief minister without any alliance. Once again, in GHCMC also, we'll be single. See, Gadbandans, Congress brought in Chandrababu Naidu, Bharatiya Janata.
Krishank, your line is frozen, but I just want to get a small piece of breaking news because I'm almost out of time, and I'll try and squeeze in a reaction from Atikur Rahman as well. You know, this is the nature of this election, ladies and gentlemen. At this time when the GHMC elections are happening, now you've got Akbaruddin Owaisi, the younger brother of Asaduddin Owaisi. He's also an MLA. He has come out with a fresh comment saying that the government should remove the samadhis of ex-Prime Minister Narasimha Rao and former Chief Minister N.T. Rama Rao, currently at the Hussain Sagar Lake. He claims that the samadhis are built on encroached lake land. The BJP has hit back at Akbaruddin and said that if anyone touches the samadhis of these two former leaders, then the AIMIM headquarters will also be demolished. So a lot of threat politics is happening to and fro between the BJP and Owaisi's party as well. Atikur Rahman, very quick last reaction from you. The high voltage things being said between the parties is once again something that is unusual to hear these things being said in a GHMC election, a civic body election.
Shiv, I do not understand the BJP's game plan, you know. If they are claiming that these are the municipal elections, yes, they have the right to seriously take any elections. But why bring in the national leaders? Are there no local leaders? That the question will be, okay, but the common man would be asking them. Besides, you know, the local issues have to be tackled locally. The national leaders coming in and that too with the communal agenda. Mind the people see BJP as a mascot of the RSS. You know, these are the times wherein they can remove this mascot of the RSS. If they are really seriously taking these elections, then the mascot of the RSS should be removed. No communal agenda, only development. This is a fine time for them to do this.
I have to say that the polarizing comments are not coming from only one side. They're coming from the other side as well. But we invited the AIMIM. Unfortunately, they've declined to be on the show 2 days in a row, even though we invited them to give their views. And therefore, you've heard these sides. We'll try and take it forward. Last day of campaigning tomorrow. I'm unfortunately out of time. Krishna Sagar, I saw you raise your hand. But we'll take this debate forward tomorrow as well. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me.